Let A be the matrix and theta value is between 0 to 2 pi, then determinant A value we should find here. So A is given as this determinant, this matrix, sorry, determinant we should find. So we can directly expand, or after using property we'll make zeros here and then we can expand here. So what we can do, see, 1 minus 1 means 0, 1 minus sine theta minus sine theta means 0. That means we should add R1 and R3. So see what we will get here, 0, 0, 1 plus 1, 2. And remaining row element will be same. Now we can find determinant. So we'll expand through R1, because in R1 we got two zeros. So this row will go, column will go, and 2, and the remaining 4 elements we should write in 2 by 2 determinant. Okay, so minus sine theta, sine square theta will come here, this is minus, so plus sine square theta, plus 1 ones are 1. So what is the answer? 2 sine square theta plus 2. Now determinant A, this is determinant A, isn't it? Determinant A we got as 2 sine square theta plus 2. We know about the domain of the sine theta, which is less than equal to minus 1. Sine theta values lies between minus 1 to 1, isn't it? Now squaring both the side. If you square both the side, so what value will come here? Minus 1, 1 won't come, 0 to 1, okay, isn't it? Because sine square will always be positive. So it will be between 0 to 1. Now we got this expression here. Now after that we should multiply throughout with 2. So we'll get 2, 0, 0. Then 2 sine square theta. See, what is our aim? We are making middle this expression as determinant A expression, isn't it? And 2 ones are 2 here. Now what else we want? Plus 2. So we'll add throughout with 2. So 2 plus 0 means 2. This will be plus 2 and 2 plus 2, 4. So this is what? Determinant of A. So determinant A value lies between 2 and 4.